Hello, this is Kitty for Transgroom TV, and we are here for the last session, the fifth session of creating a rolling coat on Fretcher the Brussels Griffon. So here you see Fretcher, still with not enough hair on the legs, but the back and the sides and the head is nice and shiny, and the hair is becoming thicker and thicker every time we see Fretcher. Let's do some preparing. So here you see me brushing with the side slicker. This is like a handle, very fun to hold. It is still a slicker and exists with the pins on one side and the pins on the other side. So one is very good to brush towards you, and the slicker, which has the pins looking away from you, is good for brushing up. And we have them in small and large. And now, as well this week, let's do some carding, and let's take out some wool and make new place in the hair curtle to come create new hairs. So every time you take all the wool out, it's going to create new hairs and harder hairs, and it makes place in the follicles to breathe. So here you see me working on the legs, and I'm really trying my best to take out the soft long hairs, which are like overgrown now because the new hair is coming. It's thick, but it's not long enough. So I have to like take out all the dirty long hairs which are still there, and to make sure between here and 4 weeks I have another layer. So that's exactly what we're going to do also at the tummy. At the tummy, you can see like the long hair is overgrown and it's like thin, and I'd like to take away as much as possible as the hair on the tummy. So here you see, you never have to be afraid of using different tools, because without knowing, I just chose my tool today and it's a Yento. So I've been using Showtech all this time, and today I'm using the Yento stripping knife. The Yento stripping knife is also a stripping knife that pulls out so much percent of the hair, and without cutting or damaging the coat. And here you see me switching to the Showtech solid stripper for the very fine hairs, for the difficult places, and the ears you see me doing here with the finger condoms. Here you see me taking out the rest of the long hairs, but now on week 10 I don't have much long hairs left anymore, so it's going to be not such a long session this time, because we have to like take out what is good, what is ripe, and the next times it's going to be easier, and it's going to, from now on, it's going to be easier and easier to maintain Fretcher's coat. It's amazing to see how quickly the hair is growing, like at the head and the ears, and it's like growing very fast, because last time the ears were like done 3 weeks ago and there was not a hair left on them anymore. And here you also see how comfortable Fretcher still is while I'm doing the head and the ears. So for me also, like a rolling coat, it's like comfortable because it's a little bit you don't pull out everything at once, you do little hairs. And I think it's more pleasant for the dogs as well. It's another advantage of the rolling coat. Here you see me using the terrier palm pad from Showtech. So I'm just pushing up the hair and seeing where the next time I have to pull out the points of the hair. So the eyes have to be nice and visible. I always strip out a little bit of this area. And of course, just on top of the head, everything needs to be nice and clean. Even this part, when you scissor, the hair is going to get very soft and curly. But when you do it regularly, you only have to take a little bit out, and then a little bit out of at the time is going to make the dog stand still and be really comfortable. So here you see me starting the back again. So I'm lifting the hairs with my left hand and pulling out the hairs which are coming loose. And I'm very much concentrating on the hair, so I strip out the good hairs by lifting them up with my left hand and letting them slowly go. I take the points which I see where the points are, and only I'm stripping the points, so I'm not going like with my fingers very thick and pulling on the hair, which is not ripe anyway. I'm only taking out the points. So every 3 weeks, by stripping the longest layer, you create a new layer which will come through the skin in 4 weeks' time. So don't skip a session. If you want to have a perfect rolling coat with different layers, don't skip a session. If you want to have a perfect rolling coat, it's very important to do it for sure, maximum all the 3 weeks. You can even do it every week, every 2 weeks. But with Fretje, as Fretje is not a dog with a lot of coat, Fretje, I would ideally say maximum every 3 weeks. I have a rough-coated Jack Russell Terrier, and Luna is her name, and I have to strip Luna every single week to maintain her rolling coat. Luna has a lot of coat and a lot of hair, and with Luna, I have to do it every single week. I'm stripping the back, and I'm doing the same again and again. I'm brushing the hair up, pulling the hair, and making sure it's all even, and it's even where I am. I'm never gonna strip out two times in the same area. I just have to do like stripping out 20% of the coat each time. And I'm trying not to go too short. I'm trying to do everywhere a little bit so it's even, so when the new layer comes out in 4 weeks, it's even. So here I'm showing you how to create an angle in the back. It's very important that the back, of course, of the around the anus, that it's clean. And the back of the tail needs to be stripped, yes, but the finishing you can do with a blending shear. And it's very important when the dog lifts his tail that you brush around the anus, brush up, brush down, brush the back of the tail down, and see, so all this area needs to be very clean and clear. So when the dog is running with the tail up, you see the angulation and you don't see any hairs getting out there or coming out, and everything has to be perfect. Now the front of the tail, as you can see here, if you take the front out too much, it will be like very bad, likely in a corner. And here I showed you with the hair how it would look like if you would take it all off. It would be like this in a corner, but you see I let the hair stand in front of the tail and it's like gradually going up. And I can also show you in this beautiful drawing here, have a look what would happen if you groom the tail with a corner and have a look how it should be. Please keep in mind that the hair on the legs is still not long enough and we are still struggling, waiting for the new hair to be coming longer so the feet don't look so narrow. Although the rolling coat is in the coat now, if we would have another 2 months and see Fretje back in 2 months' time, you would see the long hairs on the legs. Here you see me blending the sensitive areas with the Yento blender. And here you already see on the tail that all the coat is hard. I don't know if you remember the first session, but the first session, the coat on the tail was like soft and curly and fluffy, and now you can very simply see how hard the coat has become. Here you see me using the Heinegger mini clipper and I'm going between the pads, and it's very fun to use the Heinegger mini clipper. It's small, it doesn't vibrate, it's not very heavy, and it goes between the pads very well. Fretje doesn't like it very much. At the back of the pads, if this is the top of the feet and this is the bottom of the feet, I'm like holding my clipper like this, so I already have a little bit of the side, so when I afterwards take the scissor, it's easier for me to scissor. And here we go, scissoring the feet. If you don't have a lot of experience scissoring the feet, the best way is that you leave the feet on the floor and you go around the feet. And if your table is with bubbles or with stripes. You can also put your dog on a piece of paper or even a Transgroom catalog, and that will make the point of your scissor like slip away, and you won't be held up by the rubber or the uneven finish on your table. So here you see Fretcher all finished. You see the shiny coat, and it's getting thicker all the time, and Fretcher is happy. And here you see Fretcher outside in the garden. Here we go. This was the fifth session of making a rolling coat, and from now on we're expecting Fretcher to be groomed every 3 weeks. If you strip Fretcher for the rest of his life every 3 weeks, and if you only strip away the longest layer, you will have a perfect Fretcher always. So here you see the before and the after pictures of the last session of creating a rolling coat on a Brussels Griffon. So here you see the pictures of Fretcher in his first time he visited us, and now only thing you have to imagine is the feet and the legs a little thicker, because we are still waiting for the hairs to come through there. This was Kitty for Transgroom TV. Thank you so much for watching me, and if you like the video, you can also give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, don't ever hesitate to ask the questions down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you next time on Transgroom TV.